seatbelts. Please fasten your seatbelts. Loosen your shoelaces. We are entering a knock your socks off zone. I will be using notes because I want to be certain that I cover all the points I want to share with you. But also I want you to know that when you send me to Washington, D.C. to help remove Barack Obama from his public housing, I have first dibbies on his teleprompters. So if you don't mind, I'll be using some notes, even if you do mind. We have already been and experienced that the Obama Democrat avalanche years and time in office and their tyrant rule by executive order and manipulation have been a time of gathering diminishments. Looking ahead, we can see that there's really no future except to move them out of the high rent end of Pennsylvania Avenue and their ilk out of public life. All of the little and the big filaments of personal relations, structural constitutional integrity, and social cohesion with Providence as the partner, which constitute our world, have been snapped loose one after another. We are left to either frolic and wallow in the socialist paradise earmarked and led by a cadre of perennial teeth gnashers ruled by perpetual hate, guilt, and shame, or hear that historic call to strike out anew and find our way back to liberty and let freedom ring. I'm here before you seeking and asking for your endorsement for a United States Senator to partner with you to reestablish and restore the Republic. I'm also seeking your approval to defeat the radical incumbent support of the Obama Democrat march towards a socialist America as we move quickly towards Obama and Klobuchar showdown day at the political OK Corral in November. Without them, America's best days are ahead. We have a bright future, and we can unshackle our hopes and our dreams as individuals and as a proud state and country. As your endorsee, I will bring these concerns and choices before the people of Minnesota and America so that they and we can choose the destiny and the path of prosperity and the call of history and its author to live more abundantly. A clear choice of continuing on the path of gathering diminishments on the one hand with the Democrats, or on the other hand, partnering with our founding fathers and letting freedom ring with the Republicans. A friend of mine and his family were visiting the Bering Straits and touring the area with some of the experienced natives. One of the elder guides motioned to them to come over here and stand at this spot, and he pointed to the horizon and he said, "From here, you can see tomorrow. From here, you can see tomorrow." This election will decide whether President Obama and incumbent Senator Klobuchar and the progressives complete their fundamental transformation of our country into a bankrupt socialist state, where for all practical purposes there is no tomorrow, or whether we start taking back our country and restoring fiscal responsibility, limited government, and once again unleash the free market capitalism which has made the United States the richest, most powerful, and most benevolent nation in the history of the world, and in which country and state there are many bright tomorrows. The next few marks will center on money raising, campaigning, and the clear choice I offer you to kill the beast. My campaign has been one, admittedly, of under the radar and stealth campaign. I've been going after you delegates in groups, one-on-one and over the fence type strategy, like the Lone Ranger seeking good. I'm not an elected official or a former elected official. I do not represent any special interest. I want your vote of endorsement so I can represent you and what we all are, grassroots Americans and grassroots Republicans of the party. Democratic Party has positioned themselves as the Democratic wing of the Communist Party. We have not. Money raising. I have actively participated in the Elephant Club, where significant donors have been met and contacted. In introducing myself and visiting, I mentioned that upon my endorsement, I will contact them further for funding. The response has been heralded. I expect you to contact me, and we will seek you out as well. A clear choice to kill the beast. Delegates, there's much in place already by the state level and the state party, the BPOU, is the national committees and its representatives. And you, with all of your energy and determination, are just waiting for the convention to decide. I'm here because I want to be the tip of the spear, your servant, your representative, and your sentinel. We can and will win together. My role is, I will speak your words of limited government, love of constitutional structures, fiscal responsibility, and principle over personality and special interest. And you, the people, and the word, will do it all. I think that even the applause, I like the applause, but I get added on a little bit, a few seconds then. Okay. Yeah. Because I don't want to take over my time, but delegates and friends, you and I have a huge responsibility and opportunity to repeal Obamacare and remove the White House occupier and remove the local accomplice, Ms. Klobuchar, of many dastardly deeds that have been perpetrated upon Minnesota and America. All towards energy independence, stop the stifling regulations, close our borders, and cut the growth of spending in government. And like George Washington, beware of foreign entanglements and also the mischief of tyrants with the use of omnibus bills. The choice is...
Hi, I'm Kathy Joe.
The choice is yours. A candidate that represents the powers that be in special interest and wants government to work, a code word for more spending, taxes, and bigger government? Or me, Harold Shudlick, a candidate who wants to kill the beast, not just make government work, which is what we have now? Let me be clear. I don't want you to support me. I want to support and to speak for you. You don't work for me. I want to work for you. Together, we can and will make a difference. I'm Harold Shudlick, the people's choice to be your next United States Senator, and I ask for your endorsement. Now, don't be fooled and follow again those who have gotten America and Minnesota into the position of losing and defeat in the first place. When we got up this morning and looked in the mirror, did we say, today I'm going to vote for who the powers that be and who the important Republican circles told me to vote for? Because after all, they, the secret empire folks, the fortune babies, and the New World Order types, and their scribes and Pharisees, yep, after all, they have the power, the insight, and the money, and yes, let's face it, I am just a measly uninformed delegate. Or when we got up in the morning, did we look in the mirror and say, today, I'm going to do everything in my power to reestablish and restore the Republic. I don't have to remind you that this is perhaps the most important election in our lifetime and perhaps the lifetime of our children and our grandchildren. Delegates, together we will fight them till hell freezes over, and then we will fight on ice. I must say, I get some more time added on that, so that's good. I must say that it has been a pleasure and a daunting task in pursuing you delegates these last years, to the point where I believe that the time is right for us now to take a firm stand. I don't believe anybody has worked harder than you and me to get where we are now together at this convention, this place of work and reformation. You will soon decide whether we go on together or if you choose somebody else to represent you and the Republican Party. As for me, you delegates and friends in the party, in every conversation you have trained me and you have prepared me for the next step in my journey, whatever that may be. In life, as it moves ahead with as many opportunities and turns and possibilities, in the normal course of life events and challenges, or as your nominee, your endorsee, as your nominee, I will be traversing the state from Laverne to the Boundary Waters in Duluth, from Baudette to Harmony. We'll keep the light on for liberty and freedom. Now, I know we are pretty well tied up to Minnesota Nice. It has covered up a lot of mischief, hasn't it? But a recent tape I looked at mentioned that in the Petters Ponzi scheme, early on there was a request for background information and legal inquiry regarding financial wizardry. But the office of the attorney in charge said that the records were sealed and or information unavailable. Come to find out, that attorney in charge would soon become, in the course of events, the present incumbent sitting United States Senator Klobuchar. Now I know that Minnesota Nice precludes us from giving even the likes of Secretary of State, that wizard of ballot counting, and his acorn cronies and George Soros hell. So I pledge to you, as your endorsee and as your nominee, I will not give anyone hell. I'll just tell the truth and ask the questions, and it'll sound like hell. And speaking of Acorn and George Soros and Fred Chairman Bernanke, as your endorsee and nominee, I will call upon them to repent. And from their positions of authority to challenge their great wickedness and ballot manipulation, debt, deficit, and Keynesian economics that is attacking America and disciplined citizen, responsible citizenship, and reinstitute the miracle of the free market and small and large businesses, or step aside. Could we be any worse off? Because you have provided me, through example, with those two characteristics of unequal performance and uncompromising quality, I feel comfortable in standing before you and this convention. I have the experience necessary to make the right and the wise decisions in the best interests of you, the people, and of the best interests of our state and our country. I've been around long enough to see how much we have lost and the creative deception that continues to bamboozle the unaware, the innocent, and the uninitiated. Do you ever get tired of being invited to the banquet and then just as you're about to ready to go over the threshold to the banquet, you get tapped on the shoulder and told, you and your friends, you go around the side of the building and I'll toss you a chicken bone out the second floor. You can say no more of this foolishness and divisiveness by your vote for Harold Shudlick. You will soon answer those three short questions. If not me, or if not us, who? If not here, where? If not now, when? Warm and best regards and many happy tomorrows. Who's running the show is often a fairly thinly veiled mystery. I'm here because I'm betting on you. We are called to muster the courage and to address and overcome those who have a fiendish desire to dominate and control. In framing final decisions, they're not always right. They're seldom right and are indignant when proven wrong. Now, I don't have a lot of money behind me because traditionally a lot of money comes from special interests. I'm running to represent you, not special interests. Even though special interests and those movers are shakers, when you ask them, how come that election after election for a long time there's been so much excitement and then fairly quickly buyer's remorse sets in? These same movers and shakers shrug their shoulders and say, well, it's up to the delegates. That's why we are here. They say this to deflect the blame from a history of losing and bad decisions. You delegates can take charge and stop the nonsense. Vote Harold Shudlick, the people's choice. Delegates, your power has been usurped in the past up until now. Don't let it happen again. It's up to you. I'm the candidate who is drawing it to your attention, and I am on your side. You and I have the opportunity to take control and decide for yourself and ourselves to exercise the authority and the power that you alone have been given. I'm Harold Shudlick. My only special interest is you, we the people, in order to form a more perfect union. I will work for you, and together, like the story of David and Goliath, we will have the stones and the rocks to approach and to kill the beast. And we will pick up many, many stones and beasts and rocks along the way to take Minnesota and America back. From Minneapolis and St. Paul, from downtown to uptown, from Duluth to Windham, from Wayland to Baudette, we will have the light on for liberty and freedom and many bright tomorrows. If we are not even invited to the banquet, why should we be expected to clean up the dirty dishes afterwards and pay the tab? We will not go quietly into the night. We will not vanish without a fight. Delegates, I, Harold Shudlick, offer you what is of equal or greater value than any amount of dollars and name recognition can muster. I offer you the value and the power of principle over personality and special interests. I offer you and the voters in November excellent credentials, unencumbered by obligations to lobbyists and the good old boys organizations that influence so many politicians' opinion and decisions. I'm dedicated to constitutional small government principles instead of personality and special interests. I will bring forth the good side of politics and elevate the political scene this political season with your help. Delegates, let's face it, as we see the signs and revel in the noise and the pageantry of the campaign and the conventions, your decision, your check by that name, on that name of the ballot, is decisive. Look around, see the names. These people are known, some rising quickly from obscurity, amazingly, instantaneous so. But soon, all will be quiet, and then the march to November, when we slide into atheistic socialism or reclaim our birthright of liberty. We decide our efforts, we dedicate our efforts in this great cause to the Lord of the nations, and we submit the searchings and the outcome and the promise of healing to the honor and the well-being and the jurisdiction of the one of whom it is said has no time, and that time and decay has no power. Perhaps you don't know me as well as you would like, but that's why I'm here again. In the final analysis, the only thing we have is our memories of success and shortcomings, attempts, events, and people we've shared life, ideas, and dreams with. I say with confidence, you put your name on, you put your mark on my name, and they'll know you, and they'll know me. They'll know where we stand and where we are. You endorse me, and together we will join that group in history which can say, they soon forgot us, but they long remembered what we did. Where we stand, we can see many bright tomorrows for Minnesota and America. And from where we stand, we can see and sense that it's time for Minnesota and America to abandon the wanderlust of those progressive offspring and programs sired by that famous champion Democrat progressive horse race by the name of Eternal Bull. To kill the beast, and I'm going to take I apologize for going a little bit over, but with your indulgence, Mr. Chairman, kill the beast, to defeat the Marxist-Leninist empire in Minnesota and America, not with gunshed, but through the ballot box at the 100th anniversary of the advent of socialism in the Western world with the Russian Revolution in 1917. From where we stand, we can see that it is time for Minnesota and America to come home. Here we stand, we can do no other, God help us. As figuratively we are landing the plane on the runway, I leave you with a strategic thought or a parting insight, with your indulgence, Mr. Chairman. There's much about the economy, and I don't want to minimize it. But soon, and as we get closer to the election, the incumbent senator and Mr. President will embark on a unity tour that expressed sadness over the divisions that they helped create, but assuring us that they are sensitive to our angst and will continue to move towards reconciliation, understanding, and unity as we move towards November. To that we can say, incumbent Senator and Mr. President, expressing sorrow over our divisions and hoping us to overlook what has been done and adopt a structure in which we do not believe, simply for the sake of unity, will not work. It's like having the one who killed our mother wanting to be a grief counselor and now wanting us to comfort them for them having betrayed us. Okay. Mr. Chairman, Mr. Chairman, delegates, friends and guests, thank you, and together let us lead on.